Well, hello again, and welcome back to St. Paul's Cathedral, San Diego, for this week's live organ recital broadcast. Today's program has a lot to do with Johann Sebastian Bach. However, there is not a single piece by Bach on the program, but all the pieces you're going to hear are composers or specific pieces that were either inspired by him and his organ music, or those that had an influence on Bach himself in his writing. I'm going to open the program with two smaller pieces by Pachelbel, and these are very different from so many people know Pachelbel only by the famous Canon in D. His organ music, his keyboard works are really wonderful, very youthful and exuberant sounding. This opening toccata in C major really lives up to the name, and it's the toccata in its true definition, which means touch, or it's full of a lot of fast, fancy finger work and really rapid notes. Wonderful little kind of miniature piece, about 90 seconds long. In C major. The Ricercar, which follows that, wonderful experience in chromaticism and some more delicate harmonies and more richness in that piece we'll explore in these first two pieces by Johann Pachelbel. really charming little pieces that firmly set us up in the Baroque period. And we're going to move away from that, though, into Brahms. These 11 chorale preludes, opus 122, the set from which these two pieces have come, are his last compositions. He wrote these for the organ, again, in the style of Johann Sebastian Bach, for the most part, in their construction and paying homage to the great masters, he called him. And this particular chorale, O Welt, ich möchte dich lassen, is one that Brahms was pondering. It's one all about finding peace and joy at the end of one's journey of life. These are two settings from the same opus number. It's the last one, number 11, and number 3. They're very different. The first one is more of a, kind of more like one of the younger Bach chorales, where it's the chorale is harmonized and extended a little bit. And then the second setting that I'll play is just more of a free composition based on that same chorale prelude. So we get two different takes on Brahms as he ponders the end of his own life, and again, wants to go back to that Baroque style of Johann Sebastian Bach in his compositions. So here are the two settings by Brahms.
Thank you.
So good in those two pieces by Brahms, I feel you find a sense of comfort and relief, and that in some of his biographical information, that was really his process for these being his last pieces, and wanted to compose them again for the organ and pay homage to Bach. Continuing on with paying homage to Bach, Felix Mendelssohn is the one that we have so much to thank for these days, for having so much of the music of Johann Sebastian Bach present in our lives. Excuse me while I set up my pages and talk here at the same time. A lot of Bach's music had just sort of fallen out of use, and Mendelssohn was one of the ones who really was responsible for this great revival, not only of his organ music, but of the cantatas and so many other things too. And Mendelssohn's writing, particularly for the organ, is again heavily influenced by Bach. You hear that in his sonatas and preludes and fugues all over the place. This piece has quickly become one of my favorites of Mendelssohn, and it was incomplete. So it's only recently been published in a couple of collections where the editor completed it. This is a completion by Robert Gower. Only about the first, I think about 35-40% of the piece was actually composed by Mendelssohn, and then Gower takes the existing material, thematic material from the piece, and uses it to complete it wonderfully. I mean, it's just beautifully done. You can't even tell where Mendelssohn ends and the completion begins. Mendelssohn and so many composers are very, very moved by this chorale, one that we know as the Passion Chorale, O Sacred Head, or Herzlich tut mich verlangen. The setting by Mendelssohn, just absolutely gorgeous, starts with the chorale statement and then a wonderfully kind of orchestral, lush setting for the organ, as only Mendelssohn can do. And I'm going to follow that by another setting of the same chorale, the Passion Chorale by Longley, the most contemporary composer on today's program. He lived into the early 1990s. And again, as he thought of this particular chorale, he immediately springs back to Bach. But in reading in some of his biographies and notes, Longley's thoughts were, you know, Bach's setting of this chorale are absolute perfection. So I don't want to try and emulate that in any way other than using the same chorale and writing a chorale prelude. But so Longley takes us just into entirely different territory and directions that Bach does. Harmonically uses a series of kind of jarring tritone suspensions, resolutions, and appoggiaturas and things to kind of develop this sense of longing or wanting or trying to seek what everyone ultimately is seeking to find as their life concludes, or they ponder that. And this kind of brings us full descent into the Lenten theme for the season of the church that we're in right now in Lent. This chorale plays a very large part in many denominations for the season of Lent or Holy Week. So two very different settings of the Passion Chorale. We'll do Mendelssohn's first, and then Longley. And then the program will close out, going back to the Baroque period, Johann Walther in one of his transcriptions of a concerto by Torelli. Wonderful little three-movement piece. This one's in A minor. I think you're just going to enjoy it very much. It's just a wonderful, nice, fun, bouncy piece to take away some of the heaviness of the middle part of this program that I've done for you today. So we have the two chorales and then the transcription by Johann Walther. Thank you again so much for tuning in today. There's a whole bunch of information about this organ and the programs here if you go to my personal Instagram page. That's pun.gent.organist. So pun.gent.organist on Instagram. And if you go to the highlights right there at the top, there's one that says SPC organ. Click that and you'll get not only the organ specifications, but a whole bunch of close-up photos, some video clips of the workings of the organ, a whole bunch of close-up photos up in the chambers that you can't see when you're here live. So that's kind of a neat way to explore more of this fantastic instrument while we're doing these things remotely. So thank you again. I hope to see more of you back here again next week with us on Thursday at 5:30.